my name's Jane, for anyone that hasn't met me before. Thanks for joining me. This is my second effort at live streaming, slightly more technically glitchy than the first, but that's because we're trying to make it better, so bear with me. So I'm a gong practitioner, a sound therapist, and space holder is a phrase I use on my website. And people always wonder what space holding is and what it means. And I tend to identify that as being the stuff that goes around the sound. So as well as just showing up and playing and hopefully giving you an opportunity to drop into a really deep meditation, maybe get into some altered states journeying, help to release tension, both physical and mental, emotional, I like to really set the space to try and clear the energy around people physically and emotionally. And one of the main ways I love to do that is using crystals, like these little guys. And I was a skeptic too. I know lots of people come to my sessions and most people really engage with all this stuff, and then a few people are like, nah, that's all the hippie bits. I'll just lie down and wait for the gongs, which is totally fine, by the way. If that's what you want to do, we're going to get to the sounds in about 3 or 4 minutes. But I did just want to talk a little bit about some of the other stuff around my sound work, and that's why I've set these 30-minute meditations up, to give you a little kind of midweek blasts to help keep us going. This lockdown is only a few days in for most of us, but it's definitely going to get longer and longer as time goes on. So hopefully breaking up our days with little meditations, with yoga, with going for our one daily exercise, whatever that might be, is going to be really important. So these 30-minute meditations is a few minutes of science and philosophy and backstory, and then maybe about 20 of the sound. So, cosmic crystal calm. I'm going to grab my notes. The reason I called this session cosmic crystal calm is, like I said, crystals are something that is are really fundamental to my practice. Crystals ultimately are earth. They're all crystals, whether they're clear like this quartz, or really delineated like rhodochrosite, or like this lovely little sparkly citrine here. They're all kind of the blueprint of the earth. All crystals, or rocks, which I prefer to call them, come from the earth's core in the end, or from magma, from the crust. And depending on how and when they were made geologically, some of them are made by exerting great pressure on rocks together, some were created under heat. And you can see, and certainly in the rhodochrosite, the lines that look like some of the lines we see in the cliffs along our coast, especially here in Cornwall or in Dorset. And some are created by dripping, with, you know, hot liquids dripping to create clusters. So there's really interesting kind of history in every crystal that we use, whether ceremonially, whether it's an ornament and a piece of jewellery. It really contains the DNA, the blueprint of the earth. So I find that amazingly fascinating, that all these little rocks I've got all over my room here in my sound space in Cornwall are all, you know, billions of years old and carved out of the earth's history. I think that's fascinating. Crystals have been used since ancient Egyptian times, and probably before. They're seen extensively in ancient Egypt, in ancient Chinese civilization, and in the Inca and Aztec traditions. Some of the ones that people are really drawn to in those eras particularly are lapis, which is a lovely kind of bright blue stone, and carnelian, which is one I've got right here. And these are little polished tumble stones. So these are raw stones that have been polished up in a machine to make them easy to hold, and they're really nice to hold for meditation, and they're cheap, which is a good thing if you're getting into them. But yeah, these ancient civilizations used crystals for all kinds of things, really, to use them to, I guess, support their health and well-being, to encourage vitality and energy. They often were associated with good luck, with finding love, with finding your soulmates, and a lot of the time with assisting your journey beyond this realm. So they have lots of kind of esoteric history, as well as the geological science of what they contain. So to get to the sound, crystal bowls. I've got a couple here today. I actually broke one of my crystal bowls a few days ago. That's one of the only times I've cried so far this week. So next week there'll be a few more when I've got the full set back. But crystal bowls are not actually made totally of crystal. They're actually made a lot of glass, and they do have a quartz content, so they have a degree of this within them. But the thing that makes crystal bowls special, these ones in particular, is their tuning. They're tuned to 432 hertz, which means they're tuned effectively to the heartbeat of the planet, the pulse of the planet. So if you muck around with the calculator a bit and divide 432 down to 8 hertz, that's the pulse, the vibration in which the planet moves, which is quite amazing. And that's one of the fundamentals of sound healing, is that if we tune into the same vibration as what's around us, as the earth, as the atmosphere, of natural objects around us, then we are in tune with our environment, with our nature. And that's why it feels so good. We just feel completely held, completely in flow. With so much of our life, we're out of flow. We're vibrating with aggression, with stress, with anxiety. We're not vibrating at all in tune with the earth. And that's one of the reasons we feel rubbish a lot of the time. So that's definitely a reason I love sharing sound, and particularly with these magical bowls, is that they really bring you back into a kind of a natural space, into the flow you're supposed to be in. So how I use crystals with sound, I mean, these bowls is part of it, but if you are drawn to working with rocks, then I often quite like to take just the small one in my palm, and when I prepare to receive the sound, and for crystal bowls I usually quite like to be seated rather than lying down, I just take the stone in my hand and just really connect with it. Close your eyes maybe, feel it, see if you feel any heat, if you feel any tingling. You might be really surprised that certain stones or rocks really like bounce out of your hand. They feel so active, and some feel very heavy. So even if you find this stuff really kind of esoteric and kooky, it's quite nice just to see. We've got all the time in the world all of a sudden. Why not try, see what it does for you? If you are working with a crystal today, I'd invite you to take it in your hand now and just hold it loosely in your palm. Just connect with what you've chosen, connect with the stone, know why it's part of your practice today. And take a couple of deep breaths, really invoking the energy of that stone, so you know what it is you're hoping to gain from it, to share with it, to connect with it. So I've picked a few that I'm really working with at the moment. Those of you that join me on Monday night will have heard me talk a lot about carnelian. It's kind of a little orange dude here. So carnelian is a trigonal stone, so all crystals have an internal structure, a geometric structure. It's nothing to do with what they look on the outside, it's how they're structured on the inside, how they refract light and channel energy that changes how they work with us. So this is a trigonal structure, and the carnelian's really about courage and vitality, about grounding, stabilizing, and anchoring into the present moment, anchoring into where you are. So for me at the moment, I think this is an amazing stone where we're all dealing with this slightly, well, hugely new and challenging reality, and having to accept lack of movement. Our freedom feels like it's taken away for many of us. Our jobs or our careers feel like they're on hold, our relationships, our friends, and there's a lot of acceptance around that. Another stone I really like at the moment is citrine. It comes in many variations of yellow or gold. This is quite a light one. If I hold it in front of the white wall, you can see it. And citrine is a real energy enhancer. It's a healer, a cleanser. It's all about sunshine and the solar plexus, confidence, courage. Both of these are really great stones for this Aries season we're just in there. About the fire element. So citrine, and I love raw citrine, like this kind of really rough edged version. It's much nicer. And the last one I've been waving loads is quartz. This is my favourite quartz cluster. And it's quartz is kind of the master healer stone. It's, if you only have one, this is the one to get, and it's pretty much good for everything. And we're really lucky here in England. Quartz is one of the rocks that we have an abundance of naturally, particularly here in the southwest. There's lots and lots of wild quartz in Cornwall and in Devon. So if you happen to be in this part of the world and you happen to live on a quarry, then you can get out there and forage yourself some during this strange phase we're in. But quartz is a great healing stone, and it also activates others. So I can put my carnelian onto my quartz to cleanse it. So I'm thinking in the course of these little sessions, I'll probably do some on, you know, the geology and the science of rocks, on how to cleanse them, how to program them, how to use them on the body, with your chakras, with the elements, How to use them during a gong bath, really importantly for lots of us. So we'll come to all of that in good time. But in the meantime, we're going to begin today with a little bit of sound around the elements, particularly around the element of fire, which is the element we're currently ruled by in this new Aries moon. So I'll just invite you to get really comfy, to choose a comfortable seat that you can stay in for a few minutes. It doesn't need to be cross-legged. It can be legs in front of you. If you want to lie down, then do get comfy, put something under your head, maybe cover your eyes. If you haven't already got your headphones on, then please pop some in now. The nice big over-the-ear type are really good, but anything will do. It just will help you to hear the sound. Particularly these bowls will really sweep from left to right. The microphone will pick them up and throw them back and forth between the two mics. So if you haven't got earphones in, it will sound a little pitchy. And we'll just begin by opening up our sacred space. So taking a few deep breaths, breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. Inhaling and exhaling. If you're taking hold of your crystals, or maybe if you're even thinking about what shape crystal, rock, or mood might suit you, or maybe it's a colour, just hold that in your hand or in your heart if it's not a physical thing. And taking this moment to set your intention. Your intention is always, in any practice around meditation, what guides you, and particularly in sound, it's the thing that really has the most impact. So choose an intention, whether you're meditating for a reason, for a person, for a particular kind of hope, for an idea, for a dream, to manifest something, to release something. To give your meditation meaning and depth, the most important thing is always to know why you're here. So decide now, with your eyes softly closed, allow your breath to soften. Deep breath and turn your intention, your attention inwards. Energies of the intergenerational aspects of our being. center of our compass, spirit, the fifth element, that's you, me and us. What binds the void together is our vital life force, our energy. As your attention sits here, see if you can connect to your intention once more. Decide what you need to take forward from this few moments of pause and meditation today. Allow your breath to soften even deeper, drop further away from your physical being. So you enjoy 10 minutes of magical crystal energy.
Thank you.
connecting once again with your physical body, feeling your breath deepen, lengthen. Maybe taking a little sigh out and then a really deep inhale, really filling up the lungs, feeling the ribcage expand to make room for all the air. If you've been seated, maybe reaching overhead. If you're lying down, stretch your arms along the earth above your head and really reach into the back of the body, stretching up the spine. Noticing all the details of your physical being once again. And welcome back from your little mini sound journey. I've had no live chat and nothing I can see on my screen throughout this, so I've got no idea how you guys are feeling or if you could hear those sounds as clearly as they are in this room. They seemed okay on the mixer, but hopefully you can really appreciate some of the magic of these amazing instruments. They just look like glass bowls, but they're really very special with their quartz element and with their tuning to help you vibrate in frequency with the world around you. So hopefully you've had a 15 minutes or so of just dropping out of body and feeling a little more peaceful. So thank you for joining me. I'm really sorry about the slightly confused start with the addresses and the links. We'll get that figured out by Friday. These 30 minute meds are, as you've experienced, about 10 minutes or so of a little bit of storytelling, which will be maybe a bit more coherent when I'm not panicking about the technology, followed by about 20 minutes of sound. So on Wednesday we'll be focusing on the bowls, on Fridays we'll be focusing on the gongs, and on Mondays a little bit of whatever, maybe gongs, bowls, a bit of both, maybe the lovely tongue drum, which is this lovely thing here. So yeah, we'll just see how the mood takes us. Mondays is going to be always themed about the lunar energy, so depending on which sign the moon's in and what that means, we probably select instruments to go with that. So thank you so much for joining me. I hope you have a lovely rest of day and that it's sunny and beautiful where you are, like it is here in Cornwall. I won't ask for any donations today because I know that was a bit